Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am available for on-site training, contracting, and code reviews. Now in this episode, I am going to begin a series where I am going to show you how to learn modern C++. And now, the definition of what modern C++ is exactly is certainly open to debate, but let's say for the sake of these videos that it is what is considered to be the current best practices for programming in C++. The current best practices are going to change as the language evolves and as we learn more about how to write better code for modern computers. Now, the point of this particular video series is to give you the tools that you need to be able to be always writing modern C++ and learning on your own what the current best practices are. So I'm going to be starting in Windows for this particular example, and this is a very recent install of Windows 10. The only changes that I've made to it is to scale the user interface so that it is more visible when you are watching these videos later. And if you are a longtime viewer of this show, then you are probably wondering why I'm using Windows today instead of Linux, but I am going to be using Visual Studio for these examples, and specifically the Visual Studio 2017 Community Edition. Now I'm going to go ahead and download that now, and like I said, I haven't installed anything at all yet, so I'm just using the web browser that comes with Windows. This is the download that we want, is the first download here, the Visual Studio 2017 Community Edition, and that is a free download from Microsoft. Now, to actually do C++ development with Visual Studio 2017 Community, we need to choose a workload that gives us access to the C++ compilers. So we're going to use this desktop development with C++. And I think that the set of things that it is installing is pretty good. It's got Boost Test, Google Test, and CMake support, and the latest version of the compiler. So we're just going to go ahead and hit install here and wait for it to download and install the components. And this will take a little bit longer than it will on your computer because recording this screencast is actually slowing down the install process a fair bit. Okay, we have finished installing Visual Studio Community 2017, and we are going to launch it now. So installing Visual Studio is just the first tool that we wanted to install for our demonstrations for the upcoming next few episodes. So to install more tools, we're going to go to the Tools, Extensions, and Updates. Now there is a few tools that we want to install, and we want to get them from online, from the marketplace. The first tool that we want to install is Clang Power Tools. And we just hit download here, and it will automatically be queued to install the next time we restart Visual Studio. So while we're here, we want to grab one other tool. And that is Clang Format. Now we're going to go ahead and shut down Visual Studio and get another add-on from GitHub that's not in the marketplace. If we search here for the GitHub CPP Check Visual Studio extension, we can find this one from Violet Giraffe CPP Check Visual Studio add-in. Now, there are a couple of different versions of this, but this one will likely do what we need it to do. And we can see here that we have our multiple installers going, and we need to allow this Clang Power Tools and Clang Format once to finish installing. So we have installed the plugins for CPP Check, Clang Format, and Clang Power Tools. So we need a couple more things. Specifically, we need to get Clang for Windows installed, and that is easily available from the Clang website. And we're just going to go with the defaults here. And finally, we need to install the latest version of CPP Check. And for future reference, if you are installing CPP Check yourself later with the Visual Studio plugin, you can see that there is a link to it here from the Clients and Plugins list on CPP Check's website. Okay, so we have Clang, we have Clang Power Tools, we have the Clang Format extension, and we've got CPP Check extension with CPP Check installed. So now, for the conclusion for this episode, all we're going to do is launch Visual Studio and make sure that those tools are installed like we think they should be. So we can see that we have CPP Check installed here, Clang Format here, and hopefully we also have Clang Power Tools installed correctly. But that is not something that we'll be able to see until we create our first project. Be sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and check out any of the links below.